Being the architecture project coordinator, I was involved in coordinating all the architecture in the project. And part of my purview was coordinating a scale model. The project is actually 4 mega projects. So we have the Michigan Interchange, the United States Port of Entry, Canadian Port of Entry, and the bridge itself. The bridge itself, as you can see, is enormous. It's at 1 to 750. This whole project at this scale is about 20 feet long. The bridge itself is 2.5 kilometers, which right now looks about 10 feet.
I work for AECOM as a subconsultant to Bridging North America, and I'm responsible for all the visual quality, as well as the Canadian POE, architectural design, the US POE, and all those elements. It's one of those unique projects that you don't often get in your career. How many people can actually say, I worked on a border crossing that's got a bridge, that's got a new roadway? As we said, there's 4 mega projects within one. So we have 4 teams working on this entire project, each of which react daily with WDBA to discuss certain elements, whether it's the a detail of a wall or the overall feel of the whole space together. So we work as teams in 4 separate worlds, but all come together as one. And part of my role with Kerry is to look at it as an overall Archie project and compare and pull the whole 4 projects together as one, so it reads as one complete project from start to finish. Notice on the Canadian POE of the design of the thing at the moment, the model, there is a whole series of buildings. A lot of these are sort of support buildings to make this operate as a facility. So you've also got a maintenance building, you've got an energy center, x-ray machine center, you've got a pedestrian sort of passport for the pedestrians can go across the bridge. You've also got the main building, as well as the toll building, the toll office space, the toll plazas, all those things all link to link with each other. So the whole thing works as a complete operation, but they only have to speak to each other all the way around. But it's important that you understand that there's a whole series of processes, and these all buildings feed the whole process. It's not just a border crossing where you simply hold your passport and go across. There's a lot of activity to make this operate.
My name is Joshua Coulis. I'm the studio director of Peter McCann Architectural Models. This particular project, the Gordie Howe International Bridge project, is very interesting to us because it is huge in scale horizontally. It's super long and wide, and it presents very interesting problems from a model making perspective. One being, how do you capture such a large area within the limits of a space? You know, these are the constraints that we always work within. And this model particularly is quite large because of that. The architectural models that we're working on, 4 to be specific, but the largest one that we're working on right now, which is a 1 to 750 scale model, is the culmination of over 2,000 hours of work of various individuals, a team of upwards of 12 people, specifically on this project alone, throughout various stages of its construction. It takes approximately 6 months under a normal circumstance schedule, a little bit longer because of what we're dealing with the pandemic, but it is a very long and arduous process to go from first taking a look at the plans for this bridge to starting to implement laser cut parts, millwork, tension parts that actually hold up the bridge. Everything starts to come together after hundreds, if not thousands of hours going into it.
At a model scale of 1 to 750, we are doing our best to try and represent details that are familiar to people and things that are, I guess, recognizable and ubiquitous. So for example, a small truck like this, although maybe 20, 30 feet long, we try our best to put in as much accuracy so that people are familiar with something like a truck or a car or a tree. And it helps build landmarks and familiarity and details that people can understand in a model, even one that's this big. Vast majority of the work being done is done on laser cutter. So a lot of flat shapes are rendered in 2D and cut on basically layers of plastic that are layered up and glued together. But 3D printing is used to show some of the more intricate aspects of the model. Things that are a little bit harder to accomplish by hand with layers of acrylic are done in 3D printed and shown in much higher detail.
The beauty of the 3D model is that we all look at renders, we all look at 2D drawings. The 3D actually brings it real. It brings it something that you can feel and almost touch. And you get to relate to it. You begin to understand the spatial relationship. You understand the process of a border crossing. This is a very complex process for a person to move from one country to another. And this really emphasizes it. And the bridge is the star of the show that links the two elements together.
Normally you're just looking at paper on 2D and you're trying to put pieces together, but seeing the project as a whole, even at this scale, is and its enormity is pretty exciting.